Today we had 50k subscribers. 50,000. Like, how does 50,000 people want to listen to a strange Dutch accent guy? But thank you so much. Because of this, I want to make a video about 50 things you didn't know about Valorant part 2. Some of these things are completely useless, but some of these things can be useful in-game. Now, let's go into the video. If you press F1 with any agent, you get more information about the abilities. You can also do this while spectating teammates. Jet does not get higher if you jump first and then use her updraft. If you look closely to my crosshair, you see that I get higher when I stand still on the ground. The crab from the scuttle shack is a reference to the scuttle crab from League of Legends. You can't blind yourself with Omen, even if you use your blind through the teleporter. Phoenix's flashbang can break the class on ascent. The gateway from Yoru cannot break the class on ascent. However, his flashbang can. Riot Games did a great job on making this look very nice. But if you look a little bit closer, everything is wrong. There's a gap underneath the rock. They didn't take the time to finish this castle over here. And these plants aren't even 3D. These are flak. I mean, look at this. It's like they are printed. Anyway, it looks very nice from here. If you want to use your breach aftershock inside the teleporter, you have to go all the way over here. Then aim at this blue wall over here and then shoot. This aftershock will land nicely inside the teleporter. Or you can also do it from middle, over here. If you cast your smoke with Jet before you are defusing the bomb, you will stay in the animation. However, this does not make your smoke any longer. So if you want to ninja defuse, cast your smoke once, then defuse till half, then cast another smoke, and then finish the defuse. Easy peasy. After the icebox rework, they lowered a belt. Because of this, you can't look through this window anymore. And behind this, there's a very detailed room. I mean, Riot Games, please stop spending time in rooms like this and fix your glitches with Jet, please. I mean, after 3 months, they still didn't fix this how to noodle jump on Icebox. These rocks above Ascent are moving, so don't make lineups based around these rocks. I mean, I didn't do that. If you want for any reason a square crosshair, change your settings to 1-3-10-3. Not sure why you want this though. Before you ult with Yoru, cast your gateway first. When your ultimate runs out, you can go back to your gateway without the enemies hitting you. This is very handy if you just want some information or you walked into a bad spot. In the last video I said that you had to blow up these boxes, but I wasn't sure what was in these boxes. Well, a lot of people commented on my last video and apparently there's Radianite in these boxes. And also, you don't blow up these boxes, but you are stealing it. When the spike explodes, it teleports all the Radianite to your base. Apparently Brimstone said this in the tutorial, but to be honest, I rushed through the tutorial with loud drum and bass in the background, so I didn't listen, oops. It's not possible to stun yourself with your breach E. It's also not possible if you try to do this in the teleporter. There's a cute bunny and Wurmpy chilling on top of the crane in Icebox. But if you look closely, the bunny got a grenade in his hand, so I'm not sure if it's cute or scary. In the control step you can find a button called toggle walk. You can put this on or off. This will mean that you don't have to hold shift if you are walking, but you can just press it once. I always put this button on because I think it's really helpful if you want to focus purely on your aiming and not walking on the same time. What will happen if you shoot Viper's E straight up into the air? Well, it gets down on the ground and nothing will happen. If you shoot it a little bit in front of you, there will appear one thingy and it will not be a pillar, but it will be a small wall if you activate it. If you use your ulti with Yoru and you go through the teleporter, the enemies will hear it. It takes longer to shoot after your dash ability than it takes to shoot after your updraft ability. In the pre-round I always get very bored because I do basically nothing for 30 seconds. Luckily Riot Games added fun things like this one. Because I was so bored, I challenged myself to hit all the 5 things at once. How do you do that? Well, you have to crouch and aim at the wood. Then you will hit all the 5 things with one shot. Yeah, I'm not sure why I'm telling this, but if you like this video, please give a thumbs up. It really helps growing my channel. Thank you. If you want to flash mid with Sky, use your minimap. You can see exactly where your bird is at the moment. If the door is closing on top of the spike can be seen from 2 sides. But you can only pick it up from 1 side. I got the spike. On Haven, if you shoot your Reckon Dart straight up into the bell, you get a cool light show. Wow. In my last video I showed a few things you can break in Valorant. But apparently you can also break these snowmen. Thank you for everyone who said this in the comments. It's really helpful for me for my mental health in the game. because I need to break things if I don't want to tilt, you know? But apparently there are more bottles you can break, but I couldn't find them. Someone explained it to me, but I just couldn't find them. So if you know where the last few bottles are you can break, let me know in the comments again. And also, you cannot break the snowman with arrows. This is sad, because otherwise you could be cool Robin Hood, you know, but now you can't, sadly. And also, these snowmans over here are made of iron or something, because whatever I do, I can't break them, sadly. No! You can hide your Killjoy swarm grenade underneath this big belt. The enemies will see it a little bit, but it's better than destroying it in the open. If you jump while shooting your ult with Sova, you can jump very, very high. I'm not sure why they implement this, but maybe it can be useful somewhere. Let me know in the comments. If you put your ghost on and off, you can die in the wall. Then you can revive yourself with Sage. If you do this a few times, it will look like you have friends, but you actually don't have friends. The sound of Yoru's fake steps are a little bit different from Yoru's real steps. Shout out to Eggwick for finding this one out. By the way, Eggwick makes awesome content, really check him out after this video, link is in the description. If you time it correctly, you can jump on top of that box without using your updraft with Jet. You will have to crouch while in the air. This way you get a little bit more height. Talking about height, you can fly on top of this building with Ghost on split. From here you can maybe do cool minigames with your friends, if you play with a sniper or something and your friends maybe need to run to the other side. Be creative, you know. But while standing over here, I saw this giant building. And on top of that building, I saw a small light. It looked a little bit like a gateway, so there was only one logical thing to do here. I had to fly to it. So I spent literally like 10 minutes or maybe even 15 minutes to fly to that light. So after all that time, I finally reached it and I flied through the gap. And what was behind it? Literally nothing. But now I can say I'm the first person, well actually the second person, my friend over there, he was the first, but I'm the second person that went through this light. Maybe not, let me know in the comments if you ever did this, if you did, you don't have a life, sorry. But yeah, it's like I climbed the Mount Everest and I'm the very second person. If you cast your Q ability while jumping, you will get behind Sky. This is not very helpful, so don't jump while casting your Q ability. In custom games, if you put infinite abilities on, you can place your trap wire with Cypher as much as you want. This way you can make cool thumbnails. Some people were asking how I can fly and stand still so fast. In custom games you can click on cheats and the very first setting is a keybind to Ghost. Set that to a key and you can fly and stop very fast. There are two orbs around the map that you can take for ult points. Huh, everybody knows this. Yes, everybody knows this, but nobody is taking them, so please, take them. They are there for a reason, you know? On split, there's a drawing of a bicycle on the wall. There's nothing really special about this, but imagine. There's probably a 30-year-old game developer who made this drawing for this map. I think it's really funny, I'm not sure why, sorry. The enemies can only see Yoru his flashbang as soon as it hits something. Before that, you can't see the flashbang. If you stand over here and cast your gateway with Yoru, it will go all the way back to Boathouse. I got this trick from Headset Gaming, please check his channel out, he only got 127 subscribers, so maybe we can boost him a little bit, you know, we make cool Valorant montages. Also, if you cast your gateway with Yoru and you're gonna teleport to it, you will be looking at the way where you currently look at. So in this clip, you will have to do a 180 before you teleport. This way you won't be looking awkward to the wall after you teleport. Well, this is the end of the video. If you liked it, please give a thumbs up. And thanks again for the 50,000 subscribers. And let's go to that 100k now. Peace.